This time, we want to compare the creation of MEP spaces based on an IFC file in Revit with and without the linear solutions. For this purpose, we use this IFC file of an architectural model created in Archicad. In an IFC viewer, like here, for example, in BIM Collab Zoom, we see that the model could apparently be exported clearly, and now we take a look at the import in Revit. I've already linked the IFC file here in Revit and open it in a 3D view. In the first step, we create the floors in the MEP model based on the IFC architecture. With the help of the linear story table, we can take over the existing levels from the IFC. Since both the foundation and the roof are not stories, we declare them as work levels here. Now all floors are created, and via the visibility control in the control board, we hide level 6 and take a look at the rooms on the upper floor. We see that Revit has not created any architectural spaces from the IFC, but instead generates so-called direct shape objects, which have nothing to do with normal architectural rooms. This is relevant because these elements are not usually recognized by space-based software solutions. To proceed with the creation of the MEP spaces, we first create a floor plan view. I will do that here once for a ground floor. In the first attempt, we will create the MEP spaces using the native Revit commands. In doing so, we also activate the tag on placement and execute the command. Revit has now created 47 spaces, which we will have a closer look at. The first thing to notice is that two MEP spaces were not created at all. In addition, the entire core part of the building model has been combined as one MEP space. Thus, for example, the toilet rooms as well as the staircases were not considered. On the other hand, however, unwanted MEP spaces were placed in gaps and shafts. A look at the text also reveals that room names and room numbers were not taken from the IFC. Also, the MEP space naming command cannot do the synchronization. In the zoning dialog, we see all recognized rooms, but as mentioned, we only get numbered MEP spaces, which now need some elaborate reworking. Now we undo this action and are going to create the MEP spaces using the commands from Linear. For the transfer of the room numbers and room names, we can specify from which IFC parameters they should be taken. Here, these are the parameters long name override for the name and IFC name for the number. If the IFC contains other useful parameters, you can optionally transfer them to the MEP spaces during generation. Clicking on this button gives you an overview of the available parameters. I will leave it here at the room name and number in this case. Now we start a command and create the MEP spaces. The floor plan is analyzed, the MEP spaces are set, and the parameters are transferred to the corresponding elements. In this case, 24 rooms were created automatically. Let's take a closer look at the results. Directly, we can see the correct transfer of the room numbers and room names. Also, all rooms were recognized as defined in the IFC, and the MEP spaces were created accordingly. In the zoning dialog in the linear control board, we can see all created MEP spaces and can then proceed with the assignment to zones, for example. Major rework is not necessary, and we get an ideal basis for the building analysis and the subsequent load calculations. That's workflow instead of workaround.